This is Session 5, Organize Media Using Events, Ratings, and Keywords. Once we import media, we need to organize it so we can find the clips we need when we need them. The three easiest ways to organize media are events, ratings, which are sometimes called favorites, and keywords. Libraries store everything. Events are folders or bins that hold media or projects. You can create as many events as you want, but you have to have a minimum of one. And clips are added to events during import. There's three types of ratings: favorites, rejected, and unrated. Ratings can be applied to an entire clip or a range within a clip. Ratings are the easiest way to quickly build a selects reel. Keywords are the most powerful and flexible way to organize and find clips, especially for large projects. So let me show you how to create, rename, and delete a new event, how to add ratings to a clip, a clip range, or a group of clips, how to display clips by rating, how to add keywords to a clip, a clip range, or a group of clips, and how to find clips using keyword collections. Because clips are added to events during import, we need to create the event before we import the clip. For instance, let's select the People Library and say we want to create a new event for it. Go up to File, go down to New Event. Keyboard shortcut is Option N. It says, what are you going to call it? Well, if I've got happy people, I'll add an event for sad people. And I have it linked to the people group and click OK. So now I've got happy people and sad people. Each library needs at least one event. But I can get rid of an event. I don't want to have any sad people. So I'm going to right mouse click on it and say move the event to trash. Now I'm going to say, rather than happy people, I'm going to hit the Enter key and say people outside. Press Enter and create a new event. This time I'm right mouse clicking on the library. Say new event, Option N is the keyboard shortcut. And we'll say people inside. So adding events is easy. Just right mouse click on the library and select new event, or select the library, go up to File, select new event, or use the keyboard shortcuts, Option N. Well, let's just twirl this up so we don't see it. I'm going to go up to my glass blowing event because organizing clips by events happens during import. What happens if I've got the files already imported? Am I stuck? And the answer is no. There's a really fast way that you can organize clips. It's called ratings. It's these three buttons right down here in the toolbar. So I'm going to select a clip. I'm going to say, ooh, look at that. That's a good clip. So I'm going to select the clip. Notice the yellow box. We saw that when we were doing importing. With the entire clip selected, click the green star. Notice there's a bar across the top. That green bar indicates a special kind of keyword called a rating has been applied to this clip. I've said this is a favorite clip. Well, okay, great. So now I have to look for clips that have green bars on them? No. Instead, we go up to this menu right here, and I want to just look at my favorite clips. When I select favorites, every other clip has disappeared. I only see the favorite. Well, that's really cool. But what happens if I want to see the rest of them? Go back up to that menu and say, show me all clips. Oh, well, okay, here, I've got a guy that's doing glasswork. It's an incredible clip. He's doing a horse made out of glass, except it doesn't fit with the rest of the glass blowing. I really don't want that clip. So I want to reject it. Two ways to do that. You could click the red X rejection button. Notice there's now a red stripe across the top that indicates it's rejected. I never remember that. I just hit the delete key. When I hit the delete key, I don't actually delete the clip. I just flag it as saying, hey, I don't want this. So go up to this menu and say, hide all the rejected clips. Poof, gone. Now he's not erased. It's still on the hard disk. I still have access to it, but it's not displayed inside the browser. To get it back, just say, show me the rejected clips. And that's everybody that I shot down. Or just say, hide rejected clips. I see every clip except those that are rejected. Well, I want to get it back again. So click on this middle button. This is called unranked, and it allows me to see all clips. Whatever I have selected, I can say, let's not rank anybody. Notice the green bar, click the star. It's unranked. This is a really fast... Oh, look at this. Watch this. This is so cool. See this? This is the finished piece that they're creating. I want to have a favorite of it just spinning right as the guy's leg leaves the frame. I'm going to type the letter I to set an in, and I'm going to scroll forward and stop right there. That's my ending shot. I've selected a range. How? The letter I to set the start of the range, the letter O to set the end of the range, in and out. Click on my favorites. Notice the green bar just appears for the range. Click on show me the favorites, and just that part of the clip that has the favorite assigned to it is highlighted. Now the clip is still there on my hard disk. I haven't erased any media. I just made my life a lot easier by creating a selects reel, my favorite clips, based upon not the entire clip, but just a portion of it. And as you'll see in the chapter on keywords and metadata and ratings, I'll show you how you can create multiple selected ranges within the same clip. It's very cool. Let's go back to hide rejected. Well, let's do one more thing. Let's select this entire clip. Hold the command key down, select that clip. And let's select this clip. Those are the three clips. Nope, not that one. Hold the command key so I can deselect it. Where'd it go? Oh, I got fire there. I want to put a keyword on here that has fire. So we're going to click the key for keyword and add the word fire. Watch what happens in this frame right here when I hit the enter key in 2-1 woof. A blue line appears indicating that the keyword has been applied. Well, let's add another keyword on this one. We'll select the entire clip and we'll add a keyword and we'll call this one finished. And then let's select this, hold the command key down, select these clips here, and these are all where they're forming the clip, so we'll call that form. And press enter. Notice there's now a blue bar. Green indicates a favorite, red indicates rejected, blue indicates a keyword that I've assigned. As I twirl down my event, there's my keywords. This is called a keyword collection. Just show me my finished clips. There it is. Show me the ones that have fire in the shot. Instantaneous. How about the ones where I'm forming? Look at that. I can add keywords. I can add as many keywords as I want. The whole processing of keywords is a lot faster. If you remember the animation from earlier versions, the animation's gone. This means working with keywords with lots and lots of clips at the same time is a whole lot more efficient. For tiny projects, you don't need to organize clips at all. To quickly organize clips to display just the ones you like, ratings are the best. For medium-sized projects, event folders may be enough. And for maximum power and flexibility, especially for larger projects, keywords take a bit more time at the beginning, but save mountains of time during the edit. This has been an excerpt of our most recent Final Cut Pro 10 training covering workflow and editing. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. And thanks